But first tonight, no matter how fertile your imagination, who would have thought on Friday that by the end of this weekend, 60,000 or so Australian travellers would be stranded, all because of a volcano in faraway Chile? Hello? Many, of course, are asking, were the airlines just a little bit jittery? However, 6.30's Emily Rice today spoke to one woman who came within a whisker of dying, specifically because of an almost invisible ash cloud.
For many travellers, this long weekend has just dragged on and on.
Very hard. I want my boys. I miss my kids.
Travel plans for tens of thousands of Australians grounded by a geological event which erupted a week ago 11,000 kilometres away, a volcano spewing ash across Chile and beyond.
But this has been going on for centuries, and in fact the ash plume from this current Chilean volcano is wrapping all the way around the world. It's gone east, crossed the southern Atlantic, crossed the Indian Ocean, and is now in the southern ocean, and will eventually go back across the Pacific and wind around back on itself.
While the cloud created spectacular scenes near Chile, in southern skies there was little to see.
When you look at the sky, you can't tell that there's ash there. In fact, it just looks like a slight haze.
But when sucked through jet engines, the minute particles have the potential to bring down aircraft.
If you do go into a volcanic ash cloud, you must probably have engine failure. We know how deadly it can be.
The ash is extremely corrosive.
It collects on the turbine on the very hot end of the engine and melts and forms a glass-like substance, which in turn causes the engine to start deteriorating in performance.
This is what happened on a British Airways flight which flew through ash in 1982 en route from London to Australia. Four engines failed, but the pilot miraculously landed safely in Jakarta. Victorian Jean Waddell was on board and thought they were doomed.
The life jackets all fell down from their little chutes above and were about to hit the mountain before they restarted one of the engines. And he was able to gain some altitude and rise over the mountain. We just made it.
She's not afraid to fly now because of the safety precautions taken.
I'd go anywhere in a plane because I think they've got it pretty well sized up now and there's not a lot of lives lost.
But not every airline follows the same safety procedures. Air New Zealand continued many flights, changing routes and dropping its cruising altitude to avoid the ash, as did Virgin.
We have been flying under 20,000 feet. They're all telling us that it is very safe to fly in that space.
So it's perfectly possible to avoid the layer, providing air traffic and the efficiency of the aircraft allows you to fly at an elevation where there's no ash plume.
But Qantas and Jetstar only resumed flights late this afternoon, rejecting suggestions they overreacted.
Our policy is very clear. Qantas will not fly under the ash cloud. Qantas will not fly around the ash cloud.
Long-term damage to aircraft also needs to be considered. While flights were resuming, the backlog isn't expected to be cleared for days.
Many are prepared to pay a premium for transportation alternatives, from long-distance taxi fares to voyages across Bass Strait. The Spirit of Tasmania has even put on an extra 110 seats in the ferry's cinema section.
And despite disruptions, aviation experts maintain...
It's much better to be safe than sorry.